Hello everyone, welcome to Insights into Your Being. Today we're going to speak about enhancing our communication skills, effective communication strategies. This video is in continuation with the previous one. This is the part two about effective communication. So basically there are three components of communication that help us enhancing the way we speak. The first one is words. The second is our tonality, and the third is our body language. Now, body language and tonality are ignored completely. All the weightage is given to the words, whereas it is proven that words carry only 7% weightage of the entire communication. The major part of it is our tonality and also our body language. So the words are same for everyone. We use the same dictionary. What differs from person to person is the way we speak and the body language. The body language and the tone must be in sync with what we speak. The stress on the words we make makes the difference. It changes the entire meaning of the sentence. For example, if I say, I did not mean to call you stupid. And if I say, I did not mean to call you stupid. I did not mean to call you stupid. So when I'm stressing on different parts of the sentence, the meaning of the sentence changes. And that is why in our communication, we do not realize this. And we often feel that we are not able to put our point across. And we also feel misunderstood at times. The reason is, people are not able to see our intention or the behavior behind what we are saying. And that is why we feel confused. Why did I did not mean it? Why did the person not understand me, what I was trying to say? Because what is inside you is not being communicated with through your words. And that is why we need to work upon our tonality and body language. The second major part of communication is listening, the art of listening. Ignored listening, pretending listening, selective listening, attentive listening, and empathetic listening. Ignored listening is when someone is talking to you and you know it, and yet you are lost in your work. That does not make the other person feel comfortable, right? If your child comes up to you and you are not making an eye contact, you're not building rapport with them, you're just engrossed in your work. And then we may feel that why are conflicts happening? Second is to pretend that we are listening. We just nod our head, but unconsciously the communication is happening. The opposite person gets the message that you did not give the complete listening ear. When you do listen with empathy, when you enter into the person's shoes and listen attentively with all your heart, that makes a huge difference. Although in different situations, we need to apply different methods of listening, there is no doubt about it. Yet, the best method of listening is empathetic listening. You will be surprised to see how if you listen or if you give a listening ear to someone, you will see the difference in your relationship with them. When you find yourself in a situation where you are not feeling heard or feeling understood or feeling misunderstood, improve your style of communication. Avoid the using of the word but. Instead of the word but, but, always use and. If you use but, you negate the first half of the sentence. If you say, you help me, but you never support me. So you are complimenting a person by saying, you help me, but, and the sentence after that overpowers and the person retains the second part of the sentence. The word but has a lot of negativity in it. It negates the positive part of the sentence that you shared. I know it is good to be positive, but I'm not able to do that. So after, you will notice that after the word but, whatever part of the sentence comes out of your mouth is your belief. I know it is good to be positive, but I'm not able to do that. So you believe that you're not able to do that. You were a good boy, but you never listened to me. So these are a few examples. And if you say you are a good boy and it would be better if you do this, it makes a lot of difference when you join the two sentences with the word and. Use this and see the difference in your relationships. Unconsciously, you are communicating with the opposite person and conveying with your tone and with your usage of words that you are listening to them. You are understanding what they are saying. You feel understood and the other person also feels understood. This makes a lot of difference. There is minimum resistance and so minimum conflicts. Just for 2 days, just for 1 week, avoid using the word but and see the difference. Share your experience with me. Do hit the like button if you like my video and share it with your loved ones. Subscribe my channel to receive the notifications of the latest videos. So, to sum up the entire video, number one, method of effective communication is your tone and your body language should be in sync with the words that you're using. Number two, be a good listener, an empathetic listener. And number three, avoid the use of the word but. Use and or however, yet instead of it. Do share your experience through emails, or you can also leave the comments in the comment section below the video.
Love yourself.